They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they...
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I last posted. I know, so sorry, it's been a few months. A lot of things happened. So yeah, I'm just gonna tell the reasons why I haven't been posting lately, and it actually relates to today's title, today's video. But before I begin, please subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and also turn on the notification bell if you want to get notified when I post my next video. And I usually post on Sunday at 6 p.m. So yeah, if I didn't post on 6 p.m. or you know, Sunday, it's probably the next day. So yeah, I'm actually trying to be consistent and trying to, you know, go back on track. So yeah, let's get right into the video. As you can see from today's title, I'm so excited to announce I finally moved out from my family's house, from my parents' house. Not because of family problems, but because I want to, you know, build my own career and follow my passion and dreams. And I think a lot of you guys already know my passion, which is to really create content for you guys and make more videos for you guys, because that what makes me really happy when, you know, all of you guys give me comments, feedbacks, that I make you happy, that I make your day, that my video is really interesting, that what really makes me, you know, keep on going. And yeah, what did I say career? What did I mention? Is because I actually need this personal space to start this career, which is I actually started doing live broadcasting, which is selling food, selling stuff, while, you know, doing live maybe on Instagram or Facebook, or you know, promoting stuff or just to chit chat with people. That is actually my side job right now, but I am still flying, I'm still an air stewardess. So yeah, don't worry for me, okay? I'm actually still doing good. So yeah, what I haven't been posting lately is because if you have watched my previous videos, all of my videos, you know, I actually filmed them in my bedroom, most of it. The reason why I haven't been, you know, showing you more of my family's house was because there are a lot of things going on. I have a lot of family members. I have so much stuff in the living room, in the kitchen, that I can't really film anything for you guys, which made me very stressed out because I can't create a lot of content that I want to create for you guys. So that is one of the reasons why I actually moved out from my family's house to this new apartment, which I'm about to show you guys. This is not an apartment tour video. I'm gonna film it in my next video, but I'm going to show you a small clip of how my apartment looks like without furniture. It's like exactly how I actually came to view the apartment first time. So yeah, that's the clip that I'm gonna show you later. But I actually move out so I can, you know, make more content maybe in my living room, in my kitchen, and do more stuff for you guys. And actually, when I was in my, you know, previous room, previous house, I was very stressed. It made me feel like very lazy. It made me don't want to do anything at all. Didn't want to do anything at all. So yeah, those are a few reasons why I also haven't been posting. But I am back. I am finally back, and I'm so happy that I am here today, that I finally posted this video after a long time. And I'm so excited to really create a lot of content for you guys. So yeah, I know you all can't wait. So right now, I'm just gonna show you the clip of my apartment. Okay, this is the front door. Duh, cannot be any more obvious. And it leads to, you know, the living room. And there is actually a mini balcony outside, but I am not gonna show you the view because I don't want anyone to know where I'm living in currently, because I don't want to. But the view is breathtaking. Yes, and it's actually not that big. I think the whole apartment is only like 900 square feet, not even 1000, but it's big enough for my, you know, big ass. The apartment has 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms. Yep, pretty cool, pretty big, big enough for me once again. And this is my room, which is the master bedroom, and the view is also breathtaking. Lol, it's the same view. And yeah, this is the bathroom, pretty convenient also for me, so that I can finally poo and pee in peace without having anxiety, like wondering if anyone can listen to my pooping sound. I know, I'm disgusting. And also, this is the room where I put my clothes, or you know, my wardrobe or something like that. It might be my studio room in the future. And another room is my housemate's room. And yeah, my housemates, I love them there too. And this is the dry kitchen. There's actually a wet kitchen outside, so everything is pretty good. Yeah, that's about it for the apartment, the empty apartment. I'm not gonna show you my current, as you guys can see, I actually have bed right now and a lot more stuff going on in my room and in the living room and kitchen, but I'm not going to show you any of it yet. That's gonna be in the next video with all the juicy details. So actually, if you wanna, you know, move out like me, if you wanna be independent, if you wanna have your own personal space, there are a few things that you actually need to pay attention, not pay attention to, but to actually have to actually move out. So the first thing is saving. You actually need to save at least 5,000 ringgit lah in Malaysia. I'm not sure about other country, maybe similar, but at least 5,000. But it's better to have, you know, 8,000 to 10,000, and it actually depends on the apartment that you actually, you know, are, you know, the apartment that you're looking for. For example, if it's fully furnished, partially furnished, or unfurnished. For mine, as you can see, it's actually unfurnished, so I have to buy all the furniture by myself, which costs a lot. But in my next video, it's gonna be a budget apartment tour, which means it's actually affordable and it looks so good. I don't know how to explain, it actually looks quite good in the apartment, but everything is actually affordable, I think, for most people. So yeah, that's one exciting thing to look forward in my next video. And secondly, is when you wanna, you know, go for apartment hunting, maybe here are a few websites that it will help you. So I'm just gonna, you know, put it here, I'll link it below. So one of the, you know, websites that I actually went for apartment hunting is muda.my.com.my. Muda, okay, I think a lot of you guys know Muda lah. Muda means cheap, is it? Am I really a Malaysian? I don't know, but am I dumb? Yes, I'm dumb. I think in Malay it means cheap. So I think it means cheap lah, yeah. So whatever, okay. So I actually mainly use this website for my apartment hunting, and I actually searched for quite some time already. I've been looking at apartment for a few months, and finally I found one which is suitable and really nice. And you know, I actually wanted this really simple looking but clean, most importantly clean, apartment for me. So yeah, that's what I found, and I can't wait to show you guys. And a few more things that you actually need to pay close attention to is whether you have to pay for, you know, like management fees, and you actually need to pay for deposits. Depends on the owner, sometimes they want you to pay like, you know, 2 months deposit and plus 1 month rent, and you know, utility fees, stamping fees is actually like, you know, the contract that you actually need to sign, you know, that thing that is called stamping fees in Malaysia. So yeah, it's like contract fees or whatever, that also you also have to pay for that. And maybe, you know, water bill, electricity bill, and do you need Wi-Fi in the house, and blah blah blah, stuff like that. So there are a lot of things that you actually need to, you know, save up for, and here are just a few tips. So yeah, that's all I want to say. Maybe I left out a few things, I'm not sure. I'll probably cover it in my next video, which I am about to take, you know, to show you guys very soon in 1 week time. So yeah, before I end this video, I have some wise words for you guys. I'm gonna make this a routine. I'm not sure if you guys like it or not, just comment down below. So the wise words are: the pain that you've been feeling can't compare to the joy that's coming. Romans chapter 8 verse 18. So yeah, there's joy coming to you no matter what, you know, how sad or, you know, how down you're feeling, like maybe today, this week, the past few weeks, okay? If it's related to you, wow, okay? If it's not related to you, share this,
you know, wise words
with people around you and make them feel better. So don't worry, good things are coming to you. I am actually a little bit stressed out this week, not only stressed out but really really sad, because there are a lot of things that are happening currently. So this also, you know, reminds me that, you know, good things are coming soon. So yeah, that's all for today. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and also turn on the notification bell, okay? So yeah, that's all, and thank you. God bless, stay safe, be safe, take care, wear your mask always, and yeah, that's all. Goodbye.